This screencast is going to show you several of the tools available in the TextExpander editing bar. So let me show you what that is. I've created a group here called Editing Bar Snippets, and I'm going to add a new snippet here. This is a plain text style snippet, and the editing bar is this thing right across the top of the content window. We're going to go through several of those here in the screencast. The first one I want to look at is the date insertion. So let's go ahead and create a snippet around that. Today's date is colon, and then we can insert the date, and I'm going to go with the month first, and then you would have a space, and we'll do the same thing for the day, and I'm going to pick the day without the leading zero, and I'll put a comma and then the year. So now I've created that snippet. I'm going to go ahead and give it an abbreviation and a label. I'll call it today's date, X date. And it's done. So I've created my first editing bar snippet with a date. Let's see that in action. Here I am in a text editor, so I'll go ahead and type the abbreviation. And you can see it put in today's date is and inserted the date that I'm recording this screencast. Pretty clever, huh? Let's add a little bit more to that. The next editing bar tool is the time. So I'm going to go ahead and put today's date and time in. So let's go ahead and add to this one. And the time is, and I'll put the hour on a 12-hour clock with a colon in the middle with the minutes. I could put seconds if I want, but I'm going to skip that and instead put in whether it's AM or PM, but I need to put a space in there first. Put a space, and I'm going to go down and select AM, PM, and put a period there. Now I've edited that snippet. Let's go see that one in a text editor. Here I am back in my text editor. I'm going to hit a couple returns and do the abbreviation again, X date. And you can see today's date is February 19th, and the time is 1:48 PM. One of the most common uses for this snippet is to put in date and time strings in files. If you are making text files or just want to be able to quickly notate the date or time when you're writing something, this is really useful. So let me make one more, and I call this the date and time string. So there's no text in this one. It just goes straight with the year, hyphen, month, and I do that with the leading zero, hyphen, date, the leading zero again. That way they always have consistent digits. And then I'll put the time right behind that. I put a space in between them. I'll put the time with hours in a 24-hour clock and the leading zero and colon and minutes with the leading zero as well. And this is just a really quick date and time string. So I'm going to go ahead and say date time string as the label, and for the snippet, I'll go XDTS. I use this one all the time. Okay, so it's done. And let's go try that one out. Here I am in my text file again. If I go XDTS and I just put a date and time string in there, this is super useful. If you're writing down notes of a telephone conversation or you just want to record the date and time of any action you're doing on your computer, DTS and you're all set. The next menu gives me the ability to perform math on dates, so let me show you how that works. I've got this little snippet here called 2 weeks, and currently it shows today's date. And if you hit Command Enter, you'll get a preview of that. But I want to see what 2 days from today is, so I'm going to hit Command C to copy that, and then go down Command V to paste it, and I'm going to change the description. When I'm done, if I hit Command Enter, it's still going to show the same thing because I haven't done any date math yet, so let's do that. I've got the cursor right before the first entry of the date string. That's where you need to place it. Then I'm going to go up here to this menu and say add date. So I'll say add a date. So if I preview this, you're going to see it only adds 1 day. But I want to add 2 weeks. So I'm going to go into this line and change the 1 to a 14. Now it's going to add 2 weeks. So if I hit Command Enter, I get 2 weeks added to my date. This also works on days of the week. So if I say today is, and insert the day of the week, Monday, well actually today's Sunday, and I'll preview that, and you'll see today is Sunday. Now if I want to add to that, I'll say 3 days from today is, and I'll go ahead and insert the day of the week again. But before that, I will do some date math. So I'll say add day, And once again, it defaults to 1 day, but I want to make it 3 days, so I'll change the 1 to a 3. And I'll preview that. And you can see it did date math on the day of the week as well. As you can see, once you figure out these tricks, adding and subtracting dates in TextExpander is easy. This next tool in the editing bar allows you to enter special keystrokes like Enter, Escape, Return, Tab, and the Clipboard. This is very useful when you're in applications where you move between fields. A good example of this is email, so let's make a sample email for that. The reason I like this so much is because in most email applications, you can tab between the subject line and the body of the message, so you can have a snippet that has both of those items in it. So let's say I'm going to prepare a standard email, and the subject line is always going to be, "Your order has shipped." And once I type that, then I'm going to want to hit the tab key. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. And then I can type the message, "Dear customer." All right, so I've got my message built. It's got the subject line, the tab key, and then the message body. I'll go ahead and give that a label. Thank you, email. And we'll call that XTY for X, thank you. And I'm going to open my Apple Mail application now so we can see this in action. Here I am in Apple Mail, and I've got a new message started here, and my cursor is on the subject line. I'll go ahead and type XTY, the abbreviation, and you can see it typed in the subject line, hit the tab key, and then typed in the message to the customer. One of the things I did here you'll note is that there's no carriage return here at the beginning of the message. If I had put a carriage return after the tab key, it would have added an extra carriage return at the beginning of the body of the message. In addition to putting in special keys, you can also insert the clipboard. So let's say that I had some text on the clipboard that I wanted to insert into the snippet. In this case, I'm in my text editor. I'm going to go ahead and select all that text. And then I'm going to copy it by hitting Command C. Now I've got that saved to my clipboard. Let's add that to the snippet. So I'm going to change it to say, "Thank you so much for your order of our newest lead balloon." I'm going to replace that newest lead balloon, and I'll go back to the button and say insert the clipboard. And now it's going to grab whatever's in the clipboard and insert it into that snippet. So let me go back to the email. I've deleted the message, and I'm going to run the snippet again. And at this point, I've got that rocket red text in the clipboard. So I'm going to type XTY. And you can see when it created the snippet, it inserted the words "Jumbo Rocket Red Lead Balloon," where I had the clipboard contents in the snippet. Using the clipboard in a snippet can really get you out of a jam. This next tool is the cursor position tool, and it allows you to place the cursor in your snippet in any particular position or even just move it around. I use this with one of my favorite snippets for tracking expenses, so let me create that for you. It starts out with a date snippet, so I'll go ahead and create that quickly. The date snippet is in a year, month, date format, and I put a few dashes next to it and then Sparky expense at the end. Now I want to place the cursor right there in the middle of those two dashes. So I can do that with this tool right here. I go ahead and say position cursor here. And now I'm done. I'll just give it a label real quick, XEXP for expense. And I can run the snippet in my text editor. Here I am in the text editor. I'll go ahead and type the abbreviation XEXP. And it fills in the snippet and it puts the cursor right between those two dashes. I'm going to save fill-ins for a separate screencast, but there's so much you can do with TextExpander once you master the editing bar.